I'm glad that you stopped by. I am Sneha and welcome to Ikaise Anant, from unit till infinite. So if you are new to the channel, I am a mathematics professor and in the channel I am teaching you pure mathematics. And I am trying to make this abstract subject as interesting and as relatable as it can be. So consider subscribing my channel if you want to have fun with abstract mathematics. In the last video, we did convergence of the sequence and we tried to comprehend the definitions and tried to relate the definitions and the characteristic and the convergence of the sequence with real life scenarios. Today, we are going to do non-convergent sequences. So let's just start. Whenever the question of a sequence comes, the first question that we should ask to the sequence is whether you are a bounded sequence or not. And this I think I repeated enormous number of times in the last video also, that whenever there is a question of a sequence, the very first thing that you should check is whether your sequence is bounded or not. So how to check the sequence is bounded or not, it's in the other video. Link will be in the description box. Agar aapne nahi dekha hai, toh please consider watching it to know whether the sequence is bounded or not. There are tricks and there are tips. So the first thing is boundedness of the sequence. Now when the boundedness wala question comes in the mind, the sequence will give you only two types of answer. The sequence will say yes I am bounded, or it will say no I am not bounded. So there are only two types of scenario with a sequence. A sequence will be bounded or a sequence will not be bounded. Once a sequence is bounded, the second question is to find out the limit points of the sequence. So there are again two scenarios with the limit points, whether there is a single limit point or there are many limit points. Once your sequence has a single limit point, I would say that the sequence is convergent, and you know, this particular case will fall into the category of convergent sequences. But if your sequence has more than one limit point, you will say the sequence will oscillate finitely. So it's a type of non-convergent sequence, and the first type is finitely oscillatory sequences. So given a sequence, the first question is whether the sequence is bounded or not. If your sequence is bounded, the second question comes whether it has a limit point or not. If the sequence has one limit point and the sequence is bounded, the sequence is convergent, as we did in the last video. But if the sequence is bounded and with more than one limit point, we will say the sequence oscillates finitely. So agar main layman method mein bolu ya layman language mein bolu, you are given with a bounded sequence. That means there are two real numbers on the real axis such that your sequence does not cross these limits. So ye in dono boundaries ke andar hi aapki sequence hai, and there are more than one limit points. That means there are different real numbers between your bounds, such that your sequence is going somewhere and then coming back at that point, then going somewhere, then coming back at that point. That means the sequence is oscillates between these points. That means agar aapko yaad ho to limit point humne kaise define kari thi, wo points jinke aas paas inke neighborhood mein there are infinitely many members of your sequence. So aapki sequence ko aapne pehle ek boundary de di ki is boundary ke andar hi aapko rehna hai us sequence ko, aur fir aap keh rahe ho aapke paas ek se zyada limit point hai. Iska matlab wo sequence shaitani karke idhar udhar kahin bhi bhage, wo apni boundary se to bahar ja nahi sakte. और उसके बाद आपने बोला देर आर मोर देन वन लिमिट पॉइंट, तो इसका मतलब वो किधर भी भागे, आफ्टर सम टाइम्स वो उस लिमिट पॉइंट की तरफ आएंगे, फिर कहीं चले जाएंगे, फिर लिमिट पॉइंट की तरफ आएंगे और फिर कहीं चले जाएंगे. ऐसी सीक्वेंसेस को हम कहते हैं दे ऑसिलेट्स फाइनाइटली, यानी दो फाइनाइट बाउंड्स के बीच में वो घूम रही हैं इधर उधर. ऐसा नहीं हो रहा कि इन दोनों बाउंड के बीच में देर इज वन यू नो रियल नंबर जिसके आसपास वो जो सीक्वेंस है वो आपकी इकट्ठा हो रही है, क्योंकि अगर ऐसा होता तो सीक्वेंस कन्वर्जेंट हो जाती. सो आई होप दिस टिल दिस यू नो इट्स क्लियर. व्हेन विल यू से दैट योर सीक्वेंस इज ऑसिलेटरी दैट टू फाइनाइटली. सो ये हुआ फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ नॉन कन्वर्जेंट सीक्वेंस. नाउ कम्स द क्राइटेरिया, नाउ कम्स द सिचुएशन वेयर योर सीक्वेंस इज अनबाउंडेड. Now, whenever we did unboundedness of any set or any sequence, we learned that unboundedness can be of three type. Either the sequence is not bounded above, the first scenario unbounded above, or it is unbounded below, the second scenario, and third, it is both, neither bounded above nor bounded below. So unbounded, whenever your sequence is unbounded, there are three cases, you know, sub cases I would say. Either the sequence will not be bounded above, yani ek bada number mujhe nahi mil raha such that uske andar hi उस नंबर से छोटे ही यू नो आपके सीक्वेंस के मेंबर्स होंगे. सिमिलरली बाउंडेड बिलो, यानी एक छोटा नंबर मुझे ऐसा नहीं मिल रहा सच दैट ऑल द मेंबर्स आर ग्रेटर देन दैट नंबर. और बोथ आपको दोनों साइड रियल एक्सिस के ऊपर आपको दोनों ही साइड किसी भी तरह का बाउंड नहीं मिल रहा आपकी सीक्वेंस के लिए, एंड योर सीक्वेंस इज मूविंग हियर एंड देयर. नाउ कम्स जब आपकी सीक्वेंस अनबाउंडेड होती है. और एक और चीज जो कि मैंने अपने लास्ट टू लास्ट वीडियो में भी बोला था, सीक्वेंस के लिए आपको चार पांच क्वेश्चंस ही पूछने हैं. सीक्वेंसेस आपके नेबर्स होते हैं, रिमेंबर इफ यू रिमेंबर. सो जो दूसरी चीज आप पूछोगे वो अगेन ये पूछोगे वेदर द सीक्वेंस हैज लिमिट पॉइंट्स और नॉट. सो अगर आपको ऐसा पता चले, ज्यादातर ऐसा ही होता है व्हेन अ सीक्वेंस इज अनबाउंडेड, वो बाउंडेड कहीं पर भी जाकर के वो उसका बाउंड नहीं मिल रहा तो उसके लिमिट पॉइंट्स भी नहीं होते हैं. बट इन ऑर्डर टू राइट द डेफिनेशन we also include the point that no other limit points are there. But आपको ध्यान ये रखना है, if your sequence is unbounded, that means it will not have a limit point. अगर उसका limit point हो जाता है तो think about it, there will be a number जिसके अंदर ये सारे sequences, जिसके नीचे जिसके जिससे छोटे या जिससे बड़े हो जाएंगे, ठीक है. So if your sequence, अब क्या बात आ गई, if your sequence is not bounded above, यानी उसको एक bound, एक lower bound तो मिल रहा है such that the sequences, the members of your sequence are greater than this number, but उसको आगे जाकर के कोई बड़ा number नहीं मिल रहा, वो उसको front में कोई boundary नहीं मिल रही, तो इसका मतलब क्या होगा, your sequence is, we will say that your sequence is diverging to plus infinity. तो याद रखिए, if your sequence is not bounded above, that means your sequence is diverging to plus infinity, right? We never say the sequence is converging to plus infinity. ये बहुत सारे लोगों का doubt होता है, बहुत सारे लोगों को confusion होता है. जब भी plus infinity, minus infinity की बात होती है, it's about the divergence. So if your sequence is not bounded above, that means the sequence is going towards plus infinity, and we say, हमने एक term दे दिया है इसको, that the sequence diverges to plus infinity. Similarly, it's the second scenario when your sequence do have an upper bound, but it does not have a lower bound. यानी एक number ऐसा बड़ा number थी, यानी उसको boundary सामने से तो मिल रही है आगे से, लेकिन उसकी जो back वाला जो उसका portion है, या जो ऐसा कोई number मुझे real number नहीं मिल रहा, such that all the members are greater than this real number. That means your sequence is not bounded below. And in this case, in this scenario, we say that the sequence is diverging to minus infinity. सो डाइवर्जेंस के दो तरह के क्राइटेरियाज हो गए तुम्हारे पास. वन इज अनबाउंडेड अबव, द सीक्वेंस इज अनबाउंडेड अबव, वी से दैट द सीक्वेंस इज डाइवर्जिंग टुवर्ड्स प्लस इन्फिनिटी. इफ द सीक्वेंस इज अनबाउंडेड बिलो, वी से दैट द सीक्वेंस इज डाइवर्जिंग टू माइनस इन्फिनिटी. नेक्स्ट कम्स, आपके पास दोनों साइड में ही किसी तरह का बाउंड्री नहीं है आपके सीक्वेंस में, आपके सीक्वेंस बहुत शैतान है, रियल एक्सिस के ऊपर हर जगह घूम रहे हैं. ऐसे केस में आप कहोगे माय सीक्वेंस इज ऑसिलेटरी इनफाइनाइटली. सो व्हेनेवर वी टॉक अबाउट नॉन कन्वर्जन ऑफ अ सीक्वेंस, देर आर बेसिकली टू कैटेगरीज, ऑसिलेटरी सीक्वेंसेज एंड डाइवर्जिंग सीक्वेंसेज. ऑसिलेटरी सीक्वेंसेज आर दो सीक्वेंसेज दैट आर oscillatory, or I can say that there are two categories in oscillatory sequences, oscillatory finitely, oscillatory infinitely. If the sequence is finitely oscillatory, that means the sequence is bounded and it has more than one limit point. But a sequence is, if the sequence is infinitely oscillatory, that means the sequence is unbounded and it does not have any limit point. So ye to hua first category. Next is a divergent sequence. We say that a sequence is diverging to plus infinity if the sequence does not have an upper bound, or I would say the supremum, or I would say it's not bounded above. If the sequence is not bounded below, we say that the sequence is diverging to minus infinity. So this is non-convergent of the sequence. Keep in your mind that whenever a sequence is not convergent, that does not mean that the sequence is divergent, because एक पूरा का पूरा क्राइटेरिया है ऑफ ऑसिलेटरी सीक्वेंस. इफ द सीक्वेंस फॉल्स इन दिस कैटेगरी, वी से दैट द सीक्वेंस इज ऑसिलेटरी. सो अगर आप if you are talking about non-convergent sequence, you need to keep in your mind that there are two subcategories, oscillatory sequences and divergent sequences. Oscillatory sequence ke andar bhi further there are two subcategories, finitely oscillatory sequences, infinitely oscillatory sequences, and divergent sequence ke andar there are two categories, divergent to plus infinity, divergent to minus infinity. So with this, I'm gonna stop the video. If you have not subscribed it, I would say please subscribe my channel, because you know, you already understood that this is going to be fun. And by the end of this entire syllabus, I am very sure that I'm gonna make you fall in love with real analysis. So with this, bye.